They say it takes 10,000 hours to master a skill, but the piano professor says it should take a lot less. It's all about how you practice, not how long. That's what we focus on. Now, let's look at today's video.
The question, which piano concertos would be the top five among all regarding both technical and emotional aspects? Technical and emotional aspects. I'll stand back regarding technical aspects of pianism as I don't know how concert pianists judge top technical aspects. Instead, I'd have to consider technical aspects of composition, taking the line that concertos are a genre of symphonic writing. Top emotional aspects, I'll take it means music that reaches depths of feeling having universal appeal. For example, Bartok's first concerto is a top work for stirring up deep atavistic feelings, but they're not universally appealing, so it wouldn't count. Five symphonically constructed, internationally popular concertos that get listeners all gooey. Beethoven, Concerto No. 4 in G major. Beethoven, Concerto No. 5 in E flat major. Brahms, Concerto No. 1 in D minor. Brahms, Concerto No. 2 in B flat major. Rachmaninoff, Concerto No. 3 in D minor. The list really needs to be not 5 but 10, to include at least one each by Chopin in Liszt. The second concerto of Rachmaninoff, Tchaikovsky's first, the second is better, but its emotional appeal isn't as top, and Mozart's D minor K466 are the 21st, the most universally appealing of all his piano concertos thanks to a certain Danish film. Sorry, Schumann and Grieg, yours are more like concertinos in comparison. Learning the piano without spending decades on it is about working smart, not hard. You can access the Piano Professor Pack in the link below. It focuses on abusing diminishing returns to get the best results possible.